Night Flight returns with a Radio 1990.
Quite unnecessary, apart from being slightly absurd for an author to talk about his own play, for me to come here with a few words before the production of Ooh, after so many more distinguished people have spoken kindly of them. In fact, my only excuse for speaking to you now is that I am afraid their generosity found Ooh's belly far more swollen with satirical symbols than we have been able to stuff it with for this evening's entertainment. You are free to see Ubu in as many illusions as you like, or, if you prefer, just as a plain puppet, a schoolboy's caricature that represents for him everything in the world that is grotesque. A few actors have agreed to lose their own personalities so that they can mirror the minds and the souls of the man-sized marionettes we are about to see. However much we may have wanted to be marionettes, we have not quite hung each character from a string, which is not necessarily an absurd idea, but it would have been rather awkward for us. And in any case, we were never quite sure how many people we would have available for our crowd scenes. But the action, which is about to begin, takes place in Poland. That is to say, nowhere.
In paradise. The blood of the king and the nobles cries for vengeance, and those cries shall be answered.
My friend, that's quite a glib tongue you've got there. I've no doubt that were you to escape, quite a few complications would ensue. But I don't think that dungeons have ever let out even one of the honest fellows I've put here. And so, I bid you good night, and I invite you to sleep soundly.
Although I hear the rats dance a rather nice little jig around here.
And soon, they're going to bring me my big headpiece.
What's it made of, Pa-Ubu? Even if we are king and queen, we've got to watch the pennies.
Madam, my wife, it's made of sheepskin, with laces and clasps of dogskin.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yes.
But it's even more wonderful to be king and queen.
How right you are, Ma-Ubu.
Yes. You know, we owe a debt of gratitude to the Duke of Lithuania. Who
who's that?
Why, Captain Gordieu!
Oh, please don't speak to me anymore of that buffoon. Now that I've got what I wanted from him, he can go whistle for his dukedom. He won't get it. In fact, I've already put him in chains.
You're wrong, Pa'ubu. He'll turn against you.
Oh, well, I'm very sorry about that, dear little man. He has my deepest sympathies. But I'm not going to worry about him any more than I worry about that little, bugger ass.
So, you think you've finished with Bugrala?
Horn peanuts, of course. But what do you think that 14-year-old midget could do to me, anyway?
Pa'ubu, pay attention to what I say! Believe me, you should try to attach yourself to Bugrala by your good deeds.
What, dole out more money? Not likely, Horn Strumpet. You've already made me waste 22 millions.
Well, please yourself. But you'll find yourself in the soup.
Oh, fine.
No!
You'll be in the pot with me.
Listen once more. I'm sure young Bugrala will get the better of you because he has right on his side.
Oh, crap.
Oh!
Isn't it just as good to have wrong on your side as right? We have the honor to announce to you that in order to enrich ourselves, we're going to annihilate all the nobles and seize their property. Those who are condemned will be cast down into the pig-pinching machine, where they will be disembrained. Bring on the first noble! Who are you, buffoon?
Count of the tax.
What's your income?
3 million gold rose nobles.